Newsline is sort of a people-powered version of MSNBC. So anybody can come on and read stories, but not only read, also comment on them and also write their own stories. So it's sort of a giant social news platform where anybody from around the world can get their voice heard. So if you want to read an article from MSNBC, you'll find it on Newsline. If you want to read an article from CNN, you'll find it on Newsline. Any source around the world will appear on Newsline, and generally there's an interesting conversation occurring around the subject. So, you know, we like to think of ourselves as the place where intelligent people go to discuss the issues. We haven't given up because we never thought that this was the way to do it to begin with, but we've given up on the concept that an editor can pick what is going to be popular or what is going to be viral at any given moment. And so if you just kind of give people every story from around the world at any given time, the people will decide what's popular, the people will decide what's interesting, and the more people that read stories, the more people that comment on stories, the more people that forward stories to their friends, the score of those stories rises, and so the placement of those stories rises in kind on our front page.
How does Newsline drive video consumption?
Well, we did an experiment in January, right before the CES show in Vegas, where we launched a section on our site. We called it the Nightly News Discussion Club, and it was a companion to NBC Nightly News. And so what it is this, it's essentially a club that you can go to on Newsline. Go to nightly.newsline.com, and you can view every video segment from that day's Nightly News and discuss it. And so this is something that really had never been done before. Most people sit and watch the news at 6 o'clock, and if they want to discuss a segment, you know, they can turn to their wife or their husband or the kid, and that's kind of where it ends. The next day you forget about it. But now, when you see an interesting subject on the news, you can hop on nightly.newsline.com and discuss it with thousands and thousands of other people who just watched the same news segment that you watched. There are a lot of news sites who display their comments kind of newest to oldest. So when you type a comment in, you hit submit, you see your comment on top, and then you see everybody else's comments down below. And what this encourages you to do is simply read the story and react to it. And we're not really interested in that sort of discourse on the site. We want you to read everybody else's comments before you leave a comment, because that's kind of the beauty of conversation. And so what it's done is it's created this culture of discussion around Newsline. It's not a culture of sounding off. It's not a culture of yelling. It's a culture of intelligent discussion. And we have a reputation system around the site called Vinacity, where you get different branches of the Newsline logo for everything that you do on the site. So if you come onto Newsline and you've got a good courtesy rating, so you don't get a lot of abuse reports, you get your first branch. Then if you've been around for 3 months, you get your second branch. If you get a certain amount of votes on your content and your comments, you get your third branch. And so you build up these branches on the Newsline logo until you've got all six of them. And that's kind of an indication of your worth to the community and how many things you've done around the site. And having reputation systems like this in place is vital to create a culture of discussion and a culture of sort of intelligent discourse, as opposed to just people running off at the mouth.